हेलो, वेलकम टू पीजी पाठशाला। दिस इज पेपर 6 रेडिएशन बायोफिजिक्स एंड मॉड्यूल 6 एक्सरे ट्यूब एंड जनरेटर। आई एम डॉक्टर सुनील दत्त शर्मा फ्रॉम रेडियोलॉजिकल फिजिक्स एंड एडवाइजरी डिवीजन ऑफ भाभा एटॉमिक रिसर्च सेंटर मुंबई। द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल इज टू एक्सप्लेन द फॉलोइंग्स। नंबर 1, components of a medical diagnostic x-ray tube, a structure of cathode with a special reference to filament and Foxing cup, the relation between filament and tube current, a structure of anode, namely both stationary and rotating, effect of anode angle on focal spot size, construction and utility of tube envelope, tube housing and collimation, design and working of X-ray generator, automatic exposure control, that is AEC. So, as we discussed in earlier module, that is module 5, X-rays are produced when energetic electrons interact with target and convert their kinetic energy into electromagnetic radiation, that is X-rays. This task can be accomplished in a device called X-ray tube, where an electron source, that is cathode, a target, that is anode, and an evacuated path for electron acceleration is available. In addition, a source of energy is required to accelerate the electron, that is called generator. This module describes in detail the design and working principles of various components of a medical diagnostic X-ray tube and its generator. So, we will start with the X-ray tube. For production of Bremsstrahlung and characteristic X-rays, it is required that energetic electrons should heat a target. The X-ray tube provides an environment for production of X-rays and mainly consists of a cathode, an anode and a glass or metal envelope to maintain the required interior vacuum for acceleration of electrons. In addition, the X-ray tube assembly also consists of a properly shielded housing, a coolant vial bath and collimators for defining the X-ray field. A schematic diagram of an X-ray tube showing cathode, anode and a closed evacuated envelope required for producing X-rays has been shown in the figure. As can be seen from the figure, the electrons are released from the heated filament that are accelerated across a high voltage onto the target. The stream of accelerated electrons is called the anode or tube current. X-rays are produced due to interaction of accelerated electrons with the target. The X-rays emerge from the target in all directions but are restricted by collimators to form a useful beam. Sufficient vacuum is maintained inside the closed envelope to prevent the electrons from interacting with gas molecules. As can be seen in the figure, the two main circuits operate within the X-ray tube, the filament circuit and the tube voltage circuit. So, now we will see the structure of cathode. The cathode is a source of electrons in the X-ray tube. It is a helical filament of tungsten wire having typical diameter of 0.3 millimeter, surrounded by a Foxing cup and electrically connected to the filament circuit. The filament circuit provides a voltage up to about 10 volts to the filament, producing a current up to about 7 ampere through the filament. The electrical resistance heats the filament and releases electrons through the process of thermionic emission. The electrons released from the filament flow through the vacuum of the X-ray tube under the influence of positive voltage of the anode. to minimize the evaporation of tungsten from the hot surface, the filament temperature is kept at a lower level, except during operation of the tube. The magnitude of tube current depends on the magnitude of filament current and filament temperature. A small amount of thorium is added with the tungsten filament to increase the efficiency of electron emission and for prolonging the filament life. The structure of X-ray tube cathode is shown in the figure, and a photograph is also displayed in the figure. We can see from the figure that there are two types of Foxing cup. The Foxing cup, also called cathode block, surrounds the filament and shapes the electron beam width. The voltage applied to the Foxing cup is typically equal to the voltage applied to the filament, that is unbiased Foxing cup. This shapes the lines of electrical potential to focus the electron beam to produce a small interaction area called focal spot on the anode. A biased X-ray tube uses an insulated Foxing cup with a more negative voltage than the filament. The isolation of the Foxing cup from the filament and application of a negative bias voltage of the order of -100 volt creates a tighter electric field around the filament, which reduces the spread of the electron beam by increasing the repelling electric fields surrounding the filament and modifying the electron trajectories, which results in a smaller focal spot. The width of the Foxing cup slot determines the focal spot width, and the length of the filament determines the focal spot length. X-ray tubes with two focal spots usually employ two separate filament or cup assemblies. The illustration of unbiased and biased Foxing cup on the electron trajectory has been shown in the figure. The material of choice for filament is tungsten because of its high melting point, which is 3370 degrees Celsius, slow filament evaporation, no arcing, minimum deposit of tungsten on glass envelope. Emission temperature of the cathode is reached just before the exposure to reduce evaporation. In a standby, temperature is kept at plus minus 15 degrees Celsius so that 2700 degrees Celsius emission temperature can be reached within a second. Now, we will see the relation between filament and tube currents. The filament current determines the filament temperature and thus the rate of thermionic electron emission. As the electrical resistance to the filament current heats the filament, electrons are emitted from its surface. When no voltage is applied between the anode and the cathode of the X-ray tube, an electron cloud, that is a space charge cloud, builds around the filament. Applying a positive high voltage to the anode with respect to the cathode accelerates the electrons towards the anode and produces a tube current. A small change in the filament current can produce relatively large changes in the tube current, as shown in figure 6.4. The relation between filament current and tube current is shown in this figure. The space charge cloud shields the electric field for tube voltage below 40 kVp. And only a portion of the free electrons are instantaneously accelerated to the anode. Under this condition, the operation of the X-ray tube is a space charge limited, which places an upper limit on the tube current regardless of the filament current. Above 40 kVp, the space charge cloud effect is overcome by the applied potential difference and the tube current is limited only by the emission of electrons from the filament. The tube current is typically 5 to 10 times less than the filament current in the emission limited range. Higher KBP produces slightly higher tube current for the same filament current. However, beyond a certain KBP, saturation occurs whereby all the emitted electrons are accelerated toward the anode and a further increase in KBP does not significantly increase the tube current. Now, we will discuss a structure of anode. The anode of an X-ray tube is a metal target electrode which is maintained at a positive potential difference relative to the cathode. As we know that only a small fraction of electron energy is emitted as X-rays and remaining as the heat, X-rays production must be limited to avoid the damage to the X-ray tube due to heating. Tungsten is the most widely used anode material because of its high melting point and high atomic number. A tungsten anode can handle substantial heat deposition without cracking or pitting of its surface. A metal alloy containing 10% rhenium and 90% tungsten provides added resistance to surface damage. The high atomic number of tungsten provides better Bremsstrahlung production efficiency. Molybdenum having Z is equal to 42 and rhodium having Z is equal to 45 are used as anode materials in mammographic X-ray tubes because of their useful characteristic X-rays for breast imaging. So, what are the types of anode? There are two types of anodes used in medical diagnostic X-ray tubes, namely a stationary, that is fixed, and rotating anodes. The simplest type of X-ray tube has a stationary anode which consists of a tungsten insert embedded in a copper block as shown in the figure. The copper block mechanically supports the tungsten target and also removes heat efficiently from the tungsten target due to its higher heat conductivity. However, the small target area limits the heat dissipation rate and hence limits the maximum tube current and thus the X-ray flux. The stationary anode X-ray tubes are available in dental X-ray units, portable X-ray machines and portable fluoroscopy systems. In the figure, the configuration of a stationary X-ray tube has been shown. Because of their greater heat loading and consequently higher X-ray output capabilities, rotating anodes are used in majority of medical diagnostic X-ray tubes. In this configuration, accelerated electrons impart their energy on a continuously rotating tungsten target, spreading thermal energy over a large area and mass of the anode disc. The anode disc is mechanically supported within the evacuated X-ray tube by a bearing mounted motor assembly, which consists of copper bars arranged around a cylindrical iron core. The rotor is surrounded by a series of electromagnets outside the X-ray tube envelope, which is called a stator, and this combination of rotor and a stator is an induction motor. For operating the anode, alternating current is passed through the stator bindings to produce a rotating magnetic field which induces an electrical current in the copper bars of the rotor. This current induces an opposing magnetic field which pushes the rotor and causes it to spin. The anode rotation speeds are typically 3000 to 3600 revolutions per minute for low speed and 9000 to 10,000 RPM for high speed rotations. low or high speeds of the rotating anodes are achieved by supplying respectively a single phase 60 Hz or a three phase 180 Hz alternating current to the stator windings. The operation of rotating anode X-ray machine is interlocked with the rotation speed of anodes so that the X-ray tube will not be energized unless the anode is up to its full speed. This is the reason of a short delay, about 1 to 2 seconds in the production of X-rays when the X-ray tube expose button is pushed. In the figure, construction details of rotating anode has been shown. Rotor bearings are heat sensitive, located in the high vacuum environment of the X-ray tube and hence heat insensitive, non-volatile lubricant is required. A molybdenum stem is used for attaching the anode to the rotor or bearing assembly because of its very poor heat conductivity. In this arrangement, the anode is thermally isolated and is cooled by radiative emission. For dissipating the heat energy transferred to the X-ray tube injured from the hot anode as infrared radiation, the X-ray tube insert is surrounded by vial bath. Now we will see the relation between anode angle and focal spot. As has been shown in the figure, the anode is inclined to the X-ray tube axis, while the central X-ray of X-ray beam is perpendicular to the X-ray tube axis. The angle of the target surface with respect to the central ray in the X-ray beam is called anode angle. The anode angle is in medical diagnostic X-ray tubes ranges from 6 to 22 degree depending on their task except some mammography machines, and the common anode angle is 10 to 16 degree. The focal spot size of an X-ray tube can be defined in two different ways, namely actual focal spot size, that is electronic focus, and the effective focal spot size. The area on the anode struck by the electrons is called actual or electronic focal spot size, and it is determined by the length of the cathode filament and the width of the focusing cup. Figure shows anode angle and focal spot size of a rotating X-ray tube. The effective focal spot size is the length and width of the focal spot as projected down the central ray in the X-ray beam. The effective focal spot width is equal to the actual focal spot width, and hence it is not affected by the anode angle. However, the anode angle causes the effective focal spot length to be smaller than the actual focal spot length. This shortening of the focal spot length is called the principle of line focus. The relation between effective and actual focal spot length is given by the following relation. FL effective is equal to FL actual into sin theta, where theta is the slanting angle of the anode. Three combinations of anode angle and filament length is chosen to fulfill the requirements of X-ray beam in various medical diagnostic applications, as has been shown in the figure. The figure shows anode angle and effective focal spot size. The length of effective focal spot varies with the position in the image plane along anode to cathode direction. The projected length of the focal spot shortens towards the anode side of the X-ray beam, whereas it lengthens towards the cathode side of the X-ray beam. However, the width of effective focal spot does not change appreciably with the position in the image plane. Hence, nominal focal spot size is specified at the central ray of the X-ray beam, which is a perpendicular line from the focal spot to the image receptor or X-ray tube axis. Thus, reduction in anode angle to obtain a smaller effective focal spot size is limited by the size of the field of view required, because X-ray beam is cut off by the anode. The Hill effect, which is nothing but self-absorption of some of the X-rays by the anode towards the anode side of the X-ray beam, is another limiting factor in obtaining the smaller focal spot size. This is because of the fact that some of the X-rays produced at depth inside the anode is absorbed by the anode itself, that is self-absorption, due to the distance passed in the anode material. This loss of X-rays is higher for the X-rays emerging near the anode side of the X-ray beam and resulting in an inhomogeneous X-ray intensity across the beam, which is called the Hill effect. Now we will see the construction details of tube envelope, tube housing and collimation. The tube envelope, the X-ray tube envelope, is commonly made up of glass. However, tube envelopes in high performance tubes are made up of glass metal or ceramic metal. The tube envelope also contains a thinner exit window for the X-rays to minimize the absorption of X-rays in this area. For a mammography tube, the exit window is beryllium, which is having effective atomic number of 4. Due to its less absorption than glass, the tube envelope maintains the required vacuum in the X-ray tube. The X-ray tube is a vacuum-tight glass envelope, surrounds other components required for the efficient production of X-rays. The tube is mounted inside a metal housing that is grounded electrically, while surrounds the X-ray tube to insulate the housing from the high voltage applied to the tube and absorb heat radiated from the anode. Shockproof cables that deliver high voltage to the X-ray tube enter the housing through insulated opening. A bellows in the housing permits heated oil to expand when the tube is used. Often, the bellows is connected to a switch that interrupts the operation of the X-ray tube if the oil reaches a temperature exceeding the heat storage capacity of the tube housing. A lead sheath inside the metal housing attenuates radiation emerging from the X-ray tube in undesired direction. X-ray beam collimators are required to define and adjust the size and shape of the X-ray beam emerging from the exit port of the X-ray tube. The collimator assembly usually contains two pairs of collimating blades, that is adjustable parallel opposed lead shutters, and is attached to the tube housing at the exit port with a swivel joint. In the collimator housing, an optical beam reflected by a mirror of low X-ray attenuation mimics the X-ray beam. The light field and X-ray field is aligned to meet the standard specification. A simplified diagram of an X-ray tube assembly including rotating anode and heated filament is shown in the figure. Now we will talk about X-ray generator. The X-ray generator is the power source of the X-ray tube, which provides electrical power and signals required for operation of the X-ray tube. Filament heating circuit, high voltage to anode, motor drive circuit for stator windings, and controls the operational conditions of X-ray production and operating sequence of X-ray during medical examinations. A schematic diagram of the basic components of the X-ray generator is shown in the figure. It supplies current at a high voltage to the X-ray tube, that is 20 to 150 kV, needed for X-ray production. Transformers are principal components of X-ray generators, which helps in converting the low voltage supply into high voltage. The operational control is often accomplished by a microprocessor system, but electromechanical devices are also in use. Modern generators provide control of the anode temperature by monitoring the power applied to the tube and calculating the cooling times required according to the tube rating charts. The high voltage section of an X-ray generator contains a step-up transformer, typically with a primary to secondary turns ratio of 1:500 to 1:1000. In this range, a tube voltage of 100 kVp requires an input peak voltage of 200 volt to 100 volt respectively. The center of the secondary winding is usually connected to ground potential, that is center tap to ground. Center tapping to ground does not affect the maximum potential difference applied between the anode and cathode of the X-ray tube, but it limits the maximum voltage at any point in the circuit relative to ground to 1/2 of the peak voltage applied to the tube. Therefore, the maximum voltage at any point in the circuit for a center tapped transformer of 150 kVp is -150 kVp or +175 kVp relative to ground. A schematic diagram showing the basic components of the X-ray generator including AC is shown in the figure. The X-ray generators have circuitry which is designed to protect the X-ray tubes from potentially damaging overload conditions. Combinations of kVp, MA and exposure time delivering excessive power to a node are identified by this circuit, and such exposures are prohibited. Heat load monitors calculate the thermal loading of the anode based on kVp, MA and exposure time, considering the duration for cooling. Some X-ray systems are equipped with sensors that measure the temperature of the anode and protect the X-ray tube and housing from excessive heat by prohibiting the exposures that may damage the tube. Circuit designs of X-ray generator includes single phase, three phase, constant potential and high frequency inverter generators. Step-up transformers are used to generate high voltage, step-down transformers to energize the filament and rectifier circuits to ensure proper electrical polarity at the X-ray tube. The alternating current is converted to direct current and the voltage between filament and target is kept near its maximum value. The conversion of alternating current AC to direct current DC is called rectification. Single phase generator uses a single phase input line voltage source and produces either a single pulse or a two pulse DC waveform depending on the high voltage rectifier circuits. Three phase generators use a three phase AC line source, three voltage sources, each with a single phase AC waveform oriented 1/3 of a cycle, that is 120, apart from the other two, that is 0, 120 and 240. Three separate high voltage transformers are wired in a delta configuration. A bridge rectifier on the high voltage side in each circuit produces two pulses per cycle for each line, resulting in six pulses per cycle for a three phase six pulse generator. Addition of a group of three transformers in a bi-transformer configuration and additional bridge rectifiers provides 12 pulses per cycle in the three-phase 12-pulse generator. The high frequency generator is the recent choice for medical diagnostic X-ray systems. A high frequency alternating waveform up to 50,000 Hz is used for efficient transformation of low to high voltage. Subsequent rectification and voltage smoothing produce a nearly constant output voltage. High frequency has many distinct advantages, such as single phase or three phase input voltage can be used. Closed loop feedback and regulation circuits ensure reproducible and accurate KVP and MA values, and variation in the voltage applied to the X-ray tube is like three phase generator. The voltage ripple of a DC waveform is defined as the difference between the peak voltage and the minimum voltage divided by the peak voltage and multiplied by 100. So, percentage voltage ripple is equal to V max minus V min upon V max into 100. A comparison of the voltage ripple for various X-ray generator is shown in the table. Voltage ripple R of DC waveform is equal to percentage R is equal to V max minus V min upon V max into 100. And in the table, the voltage ripple is shown for each type of X-ray generator. For example, single phase one pulse self-rectified X-ray generator is having voltage ripple of 100%. Single phase one pulse full wave rectified generator is also having 100% voltage ripple. Three phase six pulse generator is having voltage ripple of 13 to 25%. Three phase 12 pulses generator is having voltage ripple of 3 to 10%. High frequency generators are having voltage ripple of the order of 4 to 15%, and constant potential generator is having lowest voltage ripple of less than 2%. Now I will give a brief overview of automatic exposure control. Automatic exposure control is a system of optimal choice of technical parameters like kilo voltage, milliampere current to optimize patient dose and image quality. Manual setting of technique parameters results in inconsistent exposures, and hence optical densities vary in screen film and image noise levels vary in digital systems. Due to this variation in exposure levels, errors, several rejects and repeats are unavoidable, and hence it is required to increase exposure consistency and reduce reject and repeat rates by a technique called AEC. This technique is based on measurement of X-ray flux at the image receptor and terminate the exposure when sufficient energy of X-ray has been deposited. AEC system may be advantageous only if it is calibrated correctly and used properly. The calibration of the system is required due to many factors, including energy dependence of the automatic exposure control detectors and image receptors and beam hardening. The figure gives the complete configuration of the AEC, which is generally used in X-ray machines. So, now we will summarize this module. A medical diagnostic X-ray tube consists of a cathode and a anode, an evacuated glass or metal envelope, a tube housing, and an X-ray beam collimator. The cathode is a heated filament of tungsten wires having typical diameter of 0.3 mm, which generates electrons by the process of thermionic emission. The focusing cup, also called cathode block, surrounds the filament and shapes the electron beam width. The length of filament and width of the focusing cup determines focal spot of the X-ray tube. The stream of electrons striking the target is called tube current. The tube current depends on filament current. The anode of an X-ray tube is a metal target electrode, which is maintained at a positive potential difference relative to the cathode. Anode is made up of either tungsten block or tungsten disc depending on the type of X-ray tube. In case of a stationary anode X-ray tube, the tungsten block is mounted on a copper rod. In case of rotating anode, the tungsten disc is mounted on a rotor via a molybdenum shaft. The anode is inclined with respect to X-ray tube axis. The angle of the target surface with respect to the central ray in the X-ray beam is called anode angle. The anode angle in medical diagnostic X-ray tubes range from 6 to 22 degree depending on their task, and the common anode angle is 10 to 16 degrees. The effective focal spot size is the length and width of the focal spot as projected down the central ray in the X-ray beam. The effective focal spot width is equal to the actual focal spot width, and hence it is not affected by the anode angle. The X-ray generator is the power source of the X-ray tube, which provides electrical power and signals required for the operation of the X-ray tube. The X-ray generator circuit includes single phase, three phase, constant potential and high frequency X-ray generators. High frequency X-ray generator has several distinct advantages and used as common choice in medical diagnostic X-ray tubes. The voltage ripple of a DC waveform is defined as the difference between the peak voltage and the minimum voltage divided by the peak voltage and multiplied by 100. Voltage ripple is highest in single phase generator and lowest in constant potential generator. Automatic exposure control system is used for optimizing the patient dose and image quality. So, this is the end of module 6. Thank you.